How are we doing there, folks? Wow, this is going to be my first sort of style vlog for the Tuesday videos, because my main exploring video is on the Fridays, so I want to make the Tuesday more of a vlog style thing, and shout outs and stuff like that, different things and bobs, bits and bobs like that. Just up Huff and Battery at the moment, just walking about, taking in the sun. Very hot. I've got the drone on my back, going to do some drone shooting as well. But yeah, so I was going to do this first video. I was going to sort of do some shout outs to some people, two channels, and someone wants to shout out, so we'll do that. Steve Pollard from Ontario, Canada, if I'm saying that right, Ontario? Yeah, maybe that's right. He said that his grandfather was in World War II and he's possibly in the bunkers in Great Britain, somewhere along the lines. Maybe some of the ones I've been to, maybe. So that's opened his eyes up. Thanks for that, Steve. And if you want me to say anything else, just let us know. Maybe a bit more history about your grandfather, maybe. Yes, put it in there. And also, there's two channels that I would like to do a shout out to. The first one is AKA the Lightworker. He does a video every Tuesday, and I'm always there to watch him. Very good quality history videos, checking out bits of history around Southeast Kent, which is that's quite good. It's good stuff. And also there's another channel called Hell on Earth, which is another exploring channel, urban exploring, and they do some great videos, great quality videos. Please check out in the description for those two channels, and also in the card above. Click them and check them out, folks. Yeah, it's absolutely amazing stuff. So if you want me to do any more shout outs for maybe your channel, or you recommend a channel, please leave a comment below and tell me why you think that channel needs or wants a shout out. Because I think the best channels are actually if you you do it weekly, so people know when you're going to do the video, when it's coming up. I do Tuesday and Fridays, so that's when I do mine. God, it's hot. You know, with the comments and stuff like that, and people, some people have sort of got a bit frustrated that I haven't commented back to them. But the trouble is, folks, I get so many comments, and it is a bit of a nightmare to try and get through them all in sort of such a short period of time. So bear with me, folks. I will comment back to your comments. It's just you've got to give me time. It's like one of the videos has got over 500 comments. You know, and that's, it's crazy. It's going out of hand. So I do work as well, so I'm trying to get it all in. Work around these things, so bear with me, folks. Please bear with me. I will answer your comments. Right, okay, for this Tuesday's video, I've got a very short video that's is basically an ROC post location in Kent, and it's unfortunately been demolished by the landowner, possibly the farmer, but there is sort of traces of it left. So check this video out. It's done a while ago, a couple of months ago, a month ago, something like that. It's a very short video, but check this out. You might be interested. All right, folks, we're at ROC post location on the outskirts of Lenham. We're just trying to look for it at the moment. Apparently the compound is still there, so we're just gonna have a look around. So yes, interesting. So we found the actual ROC post, Lenham ROC post. It's been demolished, fine. But we can actually see part of it down here. Check this out. There it is, folks. That's part of the... It's full of water down there. Chuck stone down there. But yeah, that's part of the post. Probably in the main room. It's just been demolished and chucked in the stuff and rubble chucked into it. So that's amazing, isn't it? And you got the telegraph pole there again that would have been used. Subrit, I think Subrit did say that the compound was still here. Perhaps the old farmer demolished it to make room for his crops. But yeah, that's good. Excellent. There's some posts in there from the old compound, possibly. There's the telegraph pole up there. They've just ripped it off, haven't they? Look. Just left it hanging.
No, that might be the thing, yeah. No.
That's interesting, eh? So that was it, folks. That was the ROC post that was demolished, possibly by the farmer, which is unfortunate. So I do have a big thing about trying to protect sites like this. As you know, people keep asking me for locations and stuff like that and why I don't give them out. It's vandalism, that's why I don't give them out. Now I've got the drone, done some footage of Lyddon Spout Battery. Here's a little sample. Alright, thanks very much for your support. Check out Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. Got all them going on the main channel. So yes, thanks very much folks, and I'll see you again soon. Cheerio. And these bunkers from the Second World War used to be up on this cliff. But over the years, the tide and landslides and stuff like that have made them slide into the sea. Royal Air Force, Swingate. Wow. Madness, folks. So obviously we won't be going in there, it's being used still. So